Do you have any other witness?
Yes, I would like to call Katie Sharkey to the stand.
Okay.
On the morning of October 31st, whose idea was it to go trick-or-treating throughout the departments?
It was Mr. Alon.
So it was Bob who initiated the rounds and led the group through the departments. On the way past Yassine's desk, did anyone in the group take anything besides normal trick-or-treating candy?
Yes.
Would you please share with the court what was taken from Yassine's desk?
It was a jar of pennies.
Is the person who took said jar of pennies in the room currently?
Yes.
Will you please point that person out to the court?
Oh.
No further questions.
Oh.
Really.
No more questions?
All right. No more questions, Ricky. In closing, I hope everyone here studies the evidence brought before the court and makes a fair and just decision on the matter. We are brought here today by Bob Alund, who claims he was wronged, even though multiple eyewitnesses claim to have seen him committing felonies. I submit the charges against my client be dropped, and Bob be fined 2,000 pennies for court attorney fees. He should also be submitted to inpatient kleptomaniac rehabilitation of the court's choosing. This program will help him get his way back onto a righteous path. Upon passing this program, you should be released into the community and put on probation with bi-weekly check-ins to make sure that he is staying on the straight and narrow.
Okay.
That is it, Your Honor.
Do you have any more witnesses?
No more witnesses, Your Honor.
Let me say a couple of things about this apparently is a charade that you're bringing here. Do you think a beautiful, blonde, young girl will be capable of stealing some pennies?
Yes?
Do you think so?
No.
Yes. And you came here from Afghanistan.
Yes.
You came very poor here.
Yes.
How many children you have?
Fifteen.
15. So I don't believe, this is I'm instructing the jury now. I think you should just dismiss all the charges and let we have to punish these two people here, because I don't believe this lady and this gentleman will be capable of doing what you are. So I instruct you for the countersuit to punish the Mr. Alun and Mr. Sutra.
Judge, you can't do it.
Okay.
All right, you guys gotta take a vote.
The jury gets to decide.
The
jury
now.
And the judge decides the punishment.
The punishment I want to...
Okay, no. After they decide who's guilty,
okay,
then you decide the
punishment.
Okay. Here's a paper. Like, vote. You got paper? Rip it out.
You guys would like a minute in the other room.
All right, you guys can vote. We'll get the pizza out.
Pizza going. Hey, who bought the pizzas? You might want to tell them before they vote.
You know who bought the pizza?
The pizza went up to Global Specs Charge and paid by the company.
Sparky, did you get soda?
All right.
Paper.
I'm not in the jury.
Am I in the jury or am I in
the jury? No, yeah, Dan, you can be part of the jury because we need an odd number.
I don't want to be part of the jury.
What is the name?
I think it's going to be unanimous anyway.
So there's two charges to declare. The charges of the prosecution against the defendant, and then the counter charges of the defendant against the prosecution.
Yep. So what did the...
I don't
know if the jury just saw that, but the defendant patted the judge on the back. Awesome. We got cheese pizza, we got pepperoni, we got roasted peppers, and one with sausage and pepperoni. Alright.
So what did the jury say?
Alright, who's the foreman? Sean, you're foreman.
Sean's
the
foreman.
Sean, you're the foreman.
Who's the foreman?
Sean?
I represent the foreman of the jury.
You have to.
You gotta rise.
All right.
Rise. All right, jury.
The responses. On the charges of the prosecution versus defendants, we have a hung jury.
Shocker.
Although there is majority vote saying that the defendant most likely had stolen the pennies back from the prosecution. And as for the charges against the prosecution presented by the defendant, we have a unanimous decision that the prosecution is guilty for... manifesting and stealing the pennies, which should not have been represented as Halloween candy in the first place, as he had taken the full jar rather than just one or two pennies, as if it was a Halloween treat.
Oh, you've been blocked too. What was that first part again? Even though he probably did do it, how does that work?
There's not even a decision within the jury.
The punishment, Mr. Alun is going to take Mindy and Jasim to lunch.
All right.
Yes.
I just said Mindy. Okay.
Take a little.
Okay.